Hi, my name is Steve, and I'm a grateful believer in Christ. And I'm recovering from addiction to porn, depression, and anxiety. I was brought up in a Christian family home. There were 7 brothers and 2 sisters. The whole family went to a Baptist church until my father's death and illness. We moved into a new neighborhood. There I learned to live without a father. I made new friends, and I was introduced to drawing by my older brother. I then met a guy in school who was a great comic artist. Maybe you want to draw and learn more about it. I saw a picture in a magazine. It was entitled, Draw the Pirate. I don't know if anyone remembers that. I did and was visited by a man that said I was talented and I should join their school. It cost money that we did not have. So I told him no. Seeing how sad I was, my mom went out and got me in a work study at a local art gallery where they had a school. I went for 4 years, also joined my school's concert band. My mom said at 13, we could make our own choices about church. So I stopped going. I was drifting further and further from Christ, and I didn't know it. I stopped going to church regularly. I went here and there, but never on a consistent basis. I continued to absorb all I could about visual art as well as music, my 2 passions. While I was busy learning, I started to drift away. I had no time for Jesus. I continued to work hard at the art school. There was none at my high school until 12th grade. I felt good about it. I was doing something special. I somehow got involved with the wrong people and started to drink and smoke and use drugs more and more, and I became a drunk. I lost control and felt I was going crazy. I was masking my pain with the loss of my dad, my mom bringing another man in our life who verbally abused me at the age of 9. Eventually, I stopped. But I continued to lust after women my age. Although I was using porn, my desire to take it up a notch tried the real thing. At that time, I knew I needed God in my life, so I joined the church and was baptized before leaving for college. Little did I know I would need Jesus in a big way. I left home for the first time and was excited for living on my own with my cousin. It was a new experience for me. I had to take care of myself. I needed to depend on God, but I depended on me. Bad choice. College was very exciting and tough. I did things I never did in high school, so I was at a disadvantage. I struggled, but I survived. I moved to my cousin because instead of telling her about my concerns, I told her friends. I learned a great lesson. Speak to the person who you have concerns over, but not her friends. I was going to strip clubs, drinking to dull the pain of being on my own. I watched porn more frequently. I was scared and not sure what the future held. I moved in with a guy named Art Maybank. I met him at home. He was nice enough to take me in. While I was studying, I dated a fellow classmate. I liked her a lot, but she didn't feel the same. So she said she was my girlfriend, and she was my first. So I thought that when I returned from school break, she was with a friend of mine. I was hurt. I called my mom for advice. She gave me Psalms 121. I lifted my eyes to the mountains. Does my help come from there? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not allow you, your foot, to be moved. He will not slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. That helped a lot. I worked very hard creating art that would help me get good grades. It was erotic at the time, well, sort of. I used porn magazines as pictures, as reference photos. I should have realized I had a sickness. The pain started to go away. I finished my first year and was proud of myself, but never gave glory to Christ. Around this time, I met the person who would become my wife. It was a tumultuous relationship, to say the least. We broke up and got back together more times than I can remember. Then we got two more roommates. It seemed we got along at first, but there were problems with the roommates I wasn't aware of. Second year of school, and I was still struggling. The home environment plus the problems with my girlfriend took its toll. On my 21st birthday, I tried to commit suicide. I took a lot of pills and wanted to die. I was so emotionally drained by all that was happening. One of my roommates found me and rushed me to the emergency room. Don't remember what they did, but I was given anxiety pills and my family sent for me to return home. I was so tired and drained. They took me to a doctor and was told to take it easy. I rested and went back to school. I did all I could to make it through the last few months of class. I was on academic probation and my grades slipped. I was told that I was suspended from school, so I had to forget going back because I was still anxious and still dealing with emotional issues stemming from home and girlfriend. After flunking out of college, I took several restaurant jobs, McDonald's as well as other five-star restaurants in the Atlanta area. Decided in 1980 to get married to my longtime girlfriend, even though I knew of our problems. The erratic behavior was ignored because of being blinded by love. Because of my struggles with money, I moved back home to Charleston with my new wife. I got a job at a grocery store and saw people I knew from the past. That's what happened to me. Working at a grocery store, they felt I should have done more. I did too, and felt shame for past failures. I managed to get a third shift job cleaning up the warehouse at Coca-Cola. I was soon asked to do inventory for a warehouse. I was put on second shift to help load trucks, and I was working at the grocery store too, so 10 to 16 hours a day, 12 to 16 hours a day. All the while, I was dealing with abuse from my wife. It was mostly verbal, but it was taking its toll. Then Jesus blessed us with a child, a boy I named Stephen II. His being born helped the marriage and changed me. I would take him everywhere I went. I was so happy to be a dad. I want to spend time with him that my dad did with me. On September the 11th, 1994, while at church, I was told my mother died. I was shocked. They had to help me up from the church pew. At that time, we rarely spoke because of things that happened during our childhood, through my childhood and adulthood. But at the moment, I had to forgive her. I was finally at peace with her. I still miss her. I found the internet after buying a new computer. Someone warned me about chat rooms. I paid no attention. Thinking I could deal with it, I was wrong. I started to have online affairs. I got hooked on the internet and porn. I spent unbelievable time on the internet. My wife found out and told me to get help or we were done. I went to a therapist. He was a great help. I was making progress, but I needed more time. Since it was through work, I only had X number of visits, so I had to stop. I was going to see my doctor and told I was pre-diabetic. I went to class to learn to deal with diabetes. By October, my doctor told me I was anemic. That wasn't the usual thing for guys, he told me. So I went to specialist after specialist until I was given a colonoscopy. I had it the day after Thanksgiving. They found polyps and did a biopsy and found colon cancer. That I was bleeding from there was why I had I was anemic. So on December 21st, I had surgery to remove and reroute my upper right colon. I went home to heal and came back to work up the following year after I was declared cancer-free. But it took a toll on me. I developed clinical depression. I was told that normally happens after a life-threatening sickness. After three tries, they got meds right, but I also needed counseling. By that time, the marriage was in shambles. We argued all the time. Then she served me with papers on the restraining order. Then I started to see a woman online. It was not a good idea. I was committing adultery. Addiction was the full action. I was going downhill more and more. Then I lost my job of 10 years because of being late too many times. I was crushed. No home, no job, because all because of addiction, and I struggled. Someone who knew me offered me to stay with him. That was a lifesaver. I no longer had to live in fear. I managed to get a job with my ex-boss from Cummins. He had his own gear company. Pay was minimum wage, but it helped me up for a while. I got a call that my brother Ben passed away. I was hurt. I eventually left home because I could no longer afford what the coast was paying was taking out of my check. So I moved back to Georgia to live with my baby brother. I found work, but I was struggling to make ends meet. I joined Divorce Care. It is a Christ-centered ministry like CR, but for people who are going through divorce and separation. I eventually moved to Iowa. I couldn't stay in my brother's home because I couldn't afford to pay utilities. I moved to Newton, Iowa. I stayed there with a friend and her husband. Everything was so different. I had to learn the Midwestern way. I found work right away. I found a new church, Community Alliance. They started a new celebrate recovery group. I never heard of it before. I loved the fact that it was a Christ-centered support group. It was then I did my first step study. It made me think about my life that was still in shambles. I started to see that I needed to change, but I was still deep in my addiction. It was around that time I met Karen. It was on my 50th birthday. I was online chatting and she messaged me. We talked for hours. We chatted and decided to meet. Then when I saw her, I knew she was special. We continued to travel back and forth to see each other, but it became too expensive. I prayed over it and asked, what should I do? Then I decided to move to Milwaukee. I knew it was what God wanted me to do. Was asked by her family to take care of my 97-year-old future father-in-law. I did it for 3 years. I divorced my wife. I realized I did not want to go back to all the abuse again. In June of 2010, I asked Karen to marry me. She said yes. Even though I knew I was still in addiction, and so did she. Maybe a week or so while preparing for a wedding, I got a call from a doctor who wanted to see me right away. Karen and I went and was told I had stage 2 prostate cancer. I was shocked because I already had cancer, was diagnosed in 2001. I called my family and said, I have good news and bad news. Bad news was I had cancer again. Good news was I was getting married again. I had the surgery and recovered fine. Then after the wedding, we went to Maui. Returning with hope because we wanted our own place. Since we were taking care of her dad in his house, we wanted to leave and start a new life, but no one wanted to step up and take care of him. So after 3 years of being his caregivers, I was alone, and it all made it all worse because I was isolated. I needed help. I found a support group, but it didn't look like it, because it was not Christ-centered. Your higher power could be a rock. I couldn't deal with that. I got news of two of my brothers passing away in the same year. I could not believe I was losing loved ones again. My father-in-law got really sick and was hospitalized for a long time. When he returned home, he got worse. So he went into a home and we moved into a side-by-side condo. Maybe a year later, he passed away. Karen and I found a church because it was the one we were going to was too far. We found Community Church in West Bend. But I still need to be in the Christ-centered recovery group like I was in Iowa. I need to get closer to Christ. I looked for a celebrate recovery group. I found out about the church starting a new CR group in West Bend. I was very happy. Then I started to attend meetings. I got to know the other men that had addictions like me. I was not alone anymore. I knew that the only way I could be able to surrender to God and not to temptation to porn. I realized that I needed Christ to help with my recovery because I was lost without him. Celebrate Recovery helped me to deal with my addiction to porn. It was helping me to heal from and forgive after the abuse. Steps 1, 2, 3, I had to admit I was deep in sin and needed Jesus to help with my habits and hang-ups. Then step 4, I was afraid. I was afraid to start once I began to write, but it came to me all the hurt that I caused others, and how much I lost. I was lost, and need to go of all the things that happened. The goal out of all the things that happened, the addiction, lies, and turmoil I endured for the last 11 years. Of course, the negatives were a lot more than the positives. I felt bad, but I was told by my sponsor to look. I was told by my sponsor to look for the good I did in my life. I was free. I felt like a weight was lifted from my shoulders. I faced up to my wrongs, and I repented to Jesus. I asked him to forgive me for all my wrongs. After going through the 12 steps, I needed to step out of my comfort zone. I was asked to co-lead a step study. I said yes. It was a great way to keep going, keep working by helping others, and I was helping myself. My journey continues, still struggling at times, still working the steps. I was asked to be a leader of the West Bend CR group. I continue to work on whatever Jesus wanted me to work over in my behavior. Because of CR, I now feel a new peace I never felt before to help others. My encouragement to newcomers is we all have sinned and fall short of his glory. It works if we work it. You are not alone. CR is here for you.